Okay, assalamualaikum and good morning everybody. I'm trying to recall yesterday. I think we finished somewhere here, right? We talk about this, right? We talk about the transfer function here. And then how we model the transfer function using the Scilab. Okay? Okay, until now, who has installed the Scilab at home? Tak lagi? Macam mana kamu nak belajar? Sepatutnya semalam example yang saya bagi sedikit tu, you dah try dah. Okay, kalau anyone yang belum install in your computer, go to the Scilab download punya website. Okay, and then click to this arrow. Okay, and then you akan download a software macam tu. Okay. Tunggu sampai the file completed, and then after that you just double click that one, dia akan automatically install in your computer. Okay. Hari ini saya akan cuba installkan sekali di sini dan saya akan tunjuk macam mana how to use the Scilab. Okay, ini pun dah complete, kita boleh install rasanya. Okay, kita just double click yang ni and run. Okay, just click OK, OK. Rasanya tak ada masalah. Just accept the agreement. Unless if you want to read, read it first. Okay, here also just click next. Next. And then just next. And then just install. Okay. And then wait until completed. Okay. Kita akan gunakan the software nanti. Okay, kita proceed dulu dengan the lecture. Okay, yesterday we talked that when we have this transfer function, okay, easily we can model the transfer function in Scilab using these few commands. Okay, nanti bila kita dah install nanti kita saya boleh tunjuklah how to run that function command. Okay, the next thing is that okay, when we have the transfer function, okay, I think normally we wanted to extract the data from the transfer function. For example, maybe the information about the poles or the information about the zeros. Okay, model data may be extracted from the transfer function data of linear time invariant object using one of the following command. Okay. So this command, the command NUMA, basically stand for assessing the numerator of the transfer function. Okay, so like before, when you have model your transfer function into a variable of system, so if you write NUMA system, okay, so you will get the all the root for the numerator, so basically the zero. Okay, and if you want to get the poles, okay, you use the command denom. Okay, this stand for denumerator of the transfer function. So you just put the variable of the transfer function that you want, okay? And then right away, it will get the roots for the denominator, which are the poles, okay? Okay, in earlier case, we have equate the new the variable num and also den, okay? We assign it something, okay? But in case if you have, if you don't know the numerator and denominator, you only know the transfer function, so you can use this command to extract the zeros and also the poles. Okay, with the Scilab also, we can utilize it also for block diagram. Okay, the only thing here, there is a little bit knowledge where it's not in the books about the block diagrams. Okay, let's say if we have the equation for the mass spring and damper system, we have the equation in the S domain. Basically, M multiplied by S square multiplied by YS, capital YS, plus B multiplied by S multiplied by Y, capital YS, and then plus K multiplied by capital Y as function of S equal to US. Okay? If you have a mathematical equation like this, okay? Last time when we talked about the block diagram, okay, I was showing that if we have, if we break that equation into a small equation, okay, for example, last time we have four equations, and then for each equation we draw the block diagram, and then we can combine them, okay? But for example, if you have an equation like this, okay, so this is actually a derivative equation, second order. The only thing after we transform into S domain, the equation is like this. Okay, if you have the equation like this, from this equation, you can draw the block diagram. This is the techniques, okay, how to do this. The first thing that you need to do, you need to rearrange the polynomial equation. Okay, so this is the polynomial equation. To get the highest order polynomial output on the left-hand side. Okay? So because this is the polynomial equation, right? Which is based on the S, because it is a function of S. Okay? So which one is the highest order? We have 1, 2, 3, 4 here. Okay, which one has the highest order? Okay? Basically, we look at the S with the power, higher power, okay? For this particular equation, basically, S to the power of 2 is the highest order, okay? So we need to put this on the left-hand side, and the rest we need to put on the right-hand side. So you need to arrange like this, okay? S square multiplied by YS, okay, multiply by M, should be on this side, on the left-hand side, and the other we bring to the left-hand side, right-hand side. Okay, US is already in right-hand side. Okay, so B multiply by S, multiply by YS, basically, positive here, when we bring to this side, become minus. This one also we bring to this side, will become minus, okay? So you arrange it this way, and not only that, you need to remove the constant also to this side, okay? We left the S and also YS, okay? So in that case, we need to divide this side with the M so that we can bring the M to this side, okay? So now we have the polynomial equation in this arrangement, okay, that we want. Okay, and then after you get that, the second step is to let the left-hand side be the output of the first summing point. Okay? We need to make this one to become the output of the first summing point. What is summing point? The circle, right? When we have the comparator, right? Okay? So that is the summing point. Okay? And the output of the summing point should be equal to this equation. Okay? So this is s to the power of 2 multiplied by ys. Okay? That is the second step that you need to do. Okay? And then the third step, okay, you need to manipulate the left-hand side by multiplication and integrating to get the output. What does that mean? Okay, when we concern about the output is basically here is what? What is the output? The output is ys. Y as a function of s. That is the output. You notice that because we have s to the power of 2 here, okay, we need to make this one, this arrow, until become only ys only. So what we need to do? Okay? For example, if we take the integration here, okay, basically it's same as we have 1 over s here block, and then we multiply with the arrow here. Okay? So what happened? The s and one of the s here will cancel out, so it will become only s multiplied by ys. Right? Come out from here. Right? Okay? And then again, since here still not only ys only, so we still need to integrate more. Okay, multiplying with the integration. So we put here 1 over s, so that this 1 over s will cancel out with this s, and at the end, the arrow that come out from this block will be ys. Okay? Once we get the arrow in the form of output, the response, okay, we stop from multiplying with the integration. Okay? So that is the third step. You can follow, huh? Okay. The next step, the final step, okay, sort out the first summing point by using the polynomial equation. Okay? Because if we look at the summing point here, we are still not complete because we have only the output of the summing point, right? But we still need to put the input to the summing point, right? Okay? So what is the input of the summing point? The input is of the summing point is basically whatever in the equation in the right-hand side. Okay? In this case, we have 3. Okay? For example, here, we have u as a function of s divided by m with a positive sign here. So we have an arrow which is plus u as a function of s divided by m for this one. Right? This is arrow coming in. Right? Okay? The only thing, this one also, you need to reduce so that at the end it will become only us only. So in order to do that, okay, where we have to put a block here, 1 over m. Okay? Because if we have 1 over m, and this is the arrow, and this is the us only, basically us multiply by 1 over m, we got this equation right. Okay? So now, you have your input here, one of your input. Okay? From the US, you multiply with the block of 1 over m, and then now this arrow will go to the summing point. Okay? So that is one of the equation here. But you still have two more here to go. Okay? We go to the next equation. Okay, the next equation is minus b multiplied by s multiplied by y as a function of s divided by m. Okay? So, we need to create another arrow going into the summing point. Okay? And this arrow is equivalent to minus b multiplied by s multiplied by ys divided by m. Okay? The only thing here, you notice that we have b and m is a constant. So if we put this constant as a block here, basically, we notice that this arrow will become s multiplied by ys. Because when we multiply with this block, and then we got this signal. Okay? And the only thing, later on we notice that s multiplied by ys is basically the same as this arrow, right? It is same with this arrow, that's why we can connect this to this arrow. Okay? So at the end, we find that this is a loop. Okay? This is a loop from here. We multiply with this constant, we got this one, and then it's become a summing, going to summing point with the negative sign. Okay? And then the next equation is minus k multiplied by y as a function of s divided by m. Okay? So we need another arrow going into the summing point. This one. Okay? With the signal of negative, okay, where the signal is k multiplied by ys divided by m, okay, and here the constant is k divided by m, so we put it as a block here, and we notice that this arrow will become ys only, okay, so because of this is ys, and we know that this arrow is also ys, so we just connect them together, okay. So, and then we notice that this will become another loops. Okay? So, once we finish the equation on the right-hand side, basically we complete our block diagram. Okay? So, this is the block diagram for the polynomial equation on the top there. Okay? It's not difficult, right? I think you can follow, right? Any question on this? Okay. So just nak check on the software tadi, kita dah habis ke belum install. Okay, if you finish, basically when you run your software, the Scilab software, it will show like this, okay? I think if you used to work with MATLAB, basically the user interface is basically has been designed the same way like MATLAB, okay? Where of course, you have the menu here, and then here, basically, you have the tools buttons, okay, like any window program. And then this here, basically, just a file browser, so we can you can browse the browse the directory, the folder, okay. And then here is basically your working space, This is the prompt, the arrow prompt, where you should write the command here, okay? And then on this side, you will see that there will be a browser for variable. Whenever we create a variable after we type certain command, if there is variable is being created, because when we create variable in Scilab, the Scilab will automatically allocate a memory for that variables. Okay? It will know whether you want a floating number, or you want an integer number, or you want a matrix, or whatever. They will detect themselves. Okay? And then the variable will appear here. Okay? So you can check. In fact, you can see the value also here if you want. And then in this side, basically, the command history. Okay, you can see the command history there. Whatever you have typed before will appear there. Okay? So for example, if you want to repeat that command, what you can do, you can just pick up from that history and then, and in fact, you can double click and then you just run that command again. Okay, so you don't need to type again and again. Okay? I think let's try with the some example that we have done before, that I have shown before. We have this example to model the mass spring and damper system. Okay? Where, firstly, you need to type this one. Okay? Even if you want, you can cut and paste. Okay. Okay, this command is important for working with polynomial equation. When you're working with polynomial equation, okay, where you don't define what is the value of s, okay, you need to declare this. Okay? Because otherwise, you need to declare what is the value of s. Okay? Of course, because I put the semicolon there, so it doesn't show the value. Okay? If you want to show the value, display the value, you can remove the semicolon before enter. Okay? And then let us assign this. Okay, let we assign numerator as 1. Okay, you see when I didn't put the semicolon, it will display the results. Okay, let's type this one as well. Okay, it shows you like you are writing the polynomial equation. Okay, the only thing, the higher order are put at the end. Okay, and then you can use this command to get the transfer function. The syslin command is to create a transfer function from the numerator value and also the denominator value that you assign. Okay, you notice here that once we use we assign a variable, for example num, the variable will appear here automatically. Okay, if you didn't show the results here, you can see also the value here. No problem. Okay, you can double click and then you can display it. Okay, so this is the next command. Okay, and then just return to see the transfer function. So we get the transfer function there. Okay, where we assign to a variable system. Okay. And you can see that the system variable also is shown here. Okay. So this is the numerator, and this is the denominator. Okay. And put in such a way in the form of transfer function. Okay, you need to use this command. Okay, you cannot just divide numerator with denominator. Okay, it doesn't work that way. Okay, let's say if you don't know this one, okay, you can use the command here, the next command. Okay, you can use this command to get the numerator and also the denominator. You can see we can get you can extract the numerator from the top here. Okay, when we use the command numer. Okay, similarly also we can do for the denominator using the command denom. Okay, so we got the denominator for you. Okay. So that is how we use the Scilab. It's not so difficult. Okay, let's continue with our lecture next. If we have example later on, we will go back to that. Okay. When we work with the control system, of course, in the modeling of the control system, because there are interconnection between the components, okay? So in the model also, we need to work out for the interconnection, okay? So multiple models can be manipulated using normal mathematical function, additional, and multiplication, okay? For example, when you have a model, two blocks arranged in block diagram in series, G1 and G2, okay, last time we learned that we can combine this by multiplying the G1 and also G2. Okay? And then also, for model in parallel, if the arrangement like this is known as parallel, okay? This is actually the summing point, because this is positive, so basically positive G1 plus G2, okay, which result here, okay? So that's why this block diagram basically we can just combine them by a plus sign, okay? We just do the additional, okay, when it is parallel, okay? Let's see in Scilab. Let's say we have two transfer functions here, two blocks, G1 and also G2 as a function of S. Okay, the G1 as a function of S is basically equal to S plus 4 divided by S squared plus 3S plus 2. Okay, and then the G2S is equal to 1 divided by S plus 5. Okay? And if you want to model it, okay, these two transfer function, okay, again, because this is polynomial equation, if we haven't typed this one, we need to type this one, okay, and then for G1, we can use this one. Of course, S plus 4, you can assign to new one variable, and then this one you can assign to one variables, and then put in the syslin command, or you can just type like this, okay? And then you get the G1, and then after that you get the you type for G2 like this, okay? Okay, we can try on the. I think I complete this first. Okay. And then after that, we need to find the total transfer function if both of them are connected in series. If connected in series, what we need to do? We just need to multiply them. G1 multiplied by G2. And if it is connected in parallel, what we need to do? We just need to add them. G1 plus G2. Okay, we can try on the Scilab software. Okay, since we have done this one before, so we don't need to repeat. If you repeat, also doesn't matter. Okay, we just put this command to model the G1. Okay, so that is the G1. Okay, and then this is the G2. Okay. And now let's try to combine them in series. Okay, so when you combine in series, basically we'll multiply this equation with this equation together and display the results there, okay? I think if you need to do it manually by hand, I think quite tedious, especially to multiply this one with this one, okay? The top one doesn't matter lah, because it's only multiply with one, okay? And then for additional, okay, so when we plus this, basically, they will calculate for you how much what should be the result is. Okay, basically we plus this one we plus this the other one before. Okay, so we get this result. And even the additional, if you want to do it by hand, I think it's quite time consuming. Okay. Okay, why I ask you to use this software? Okay, of course, when you learn the control system, you need to learn also doing manually by hand. In fact, in the exam, I didn't use the software also. I asked you to do manually. Okay, but this software can help you. Okay, for example, when you do the assignment, you can utilize this software to check whether what you do is correct or not. Okay, because I know when you do by hand, it is quite tedious. Okay, you can easily do the mistake. Okay, so easily you can check whether your answer is correct or not by running this Scilab together. Okay, so every time you do solving your problem, you can utilize Scilab, okay, to check your answer. Okay, let's look for if we have interconnection which involve the feedback loops. Okay, let's say if we have a closed loop like this, where we have a block of G1 here, and then a block of G2 as a feedback. Okay, so how are we going to simplify this to become only one block in by using this Scilabs? Okay, again, you need to set the equation in polynomials. Okay, declare this as, and then after that you need to model the G1. Okay, the value of the G1 and G2 is similar as before. Okay, so we just assign that one, G1, and also assign the G2. Okay, if you have done it before, you don't need to repeat it. But if you don't, if you repeat it, doesn't matter. It will override. Okay. Okay. When we have this G1 and G2, okay, we learned that in block diagram reduction, if we want to reduce this one to become one block, okay, we need to follow this equation, right? The G1 will become here, and G1 become here, and then this is G2, and then if this is minus, and then here become plus, okay? And then we substitute what is the G1, what is the G2 into this equation, and then we try to simplify the equation, okay? Although it looks very simple, but sometimes it took long time as well, okay, to do that. Okay? And in Scilab, what you need to do, you need only to do this. You have G1, and then for loop like this, for closed loop, you just need to use this sign. Okay? Where the sign of division here, together with the dot. Okay? And then G2 here. Okay? With that simple command, you get the same equation like this. Okay? So how easy it is? Yes? Masuk negatif lah. Tak, bila yang ini dia consider yang ini negatif. Kan? Unless kalau benda ni positif, maksudnya rasanya G2 ni juga kena masukkan sebagai negatif. Yes. Okay, rasanya itu soalan baik. Okay, sebab yang ini dia assume yang ini adalah negative feedback. Okay, this one dia assume yang ini adalah negative feedback. The best way semasa you modelkan the G2 tu, you siap-siap letakkan negative kat situ. Okay. Okay, let's say kalau kita ada closed loop like this. Okay, the feedback is unity. Unity maksudnya the feedback is equal to minus 1. Right? Okay. So, if you have a unity feedback like this, okay, to do the closed loop, okay, you can assign satu variables dengan transfer function 1/1. Okay? This is for feedback nanti. Okay? Transfer function 1/1. And then after that, buat sama macam tadi. Okay? Di sini sebab blok ini kita perlu combine dahulu. Jadi kita kalikan dia sebab dia in series. G1 kali G2. And then because it has a unity feedback here, so we just put slash point B. Okay? So that will do the calculation for do the transfer function for this. Okay? Okay, dalam kursus ini sebenarnya you will notice you should pick up lah, there are so many shortcut yang yang I'm introducing kan. Okay? Yang mana it is a good when you solving your problem, especially during the exam. Sebab kalau you buat dengan cara, you boleh buat dengan cara yang panjang. Kan? Okay? Tapi kalau you tahu the shortcut-shortcut macam ini, memang banyak benda boleh dibuat dengan cepat. Okay? Sebab yang ini pun, basically hari itu saya katakan daripada sini ke sini pun, kalau kita compare dengan mathematical punya solution, basically itu pun dah shortcut. Right? Okay? Okay, let's kita try dekat software. Okay, kita dah ada yang ini. Kita dah declare dua model ini. The only thing, kita just need to assign this command saja for closed loop. Okay, kita just paste. And then kita enter. Okay, so you get the closed loop transfer function. Okay. And then again, for this one, we need to model this. Okay, for the unity feedback. Okay, and then paste here. Enter, so you get a unity feedback there. Okay, and then for the closed loop unity. Okay, oops. Okay, so you get the answer there. Okay, so it is so easy using this Scilab. I hope from now on you use the Scilab everywhere. Any class, you gunakan Scilab untuk solve your mathematical equation. Yes? Okay. Okay, kalau you tengok ini, macam ini, the feedback block is this one. Betul tak? Tapi bagi ini, the feedback block is basically is unity. Unity is basically is equal to 1. Okay, bila equal to 1, kita kena assign as a transfer function juga. Jadi kita declare dia sebagai B, syslin 1/1. Okay, itu yang kita dapat. Kita dapat this one. Okay. Dan sebab nanti kita nak gunakan di sini. Okay. Sebab kita tak boleh just letakkan satu di sini. Okay. You need to letakkan sebagai transfer function. Okay, ini little bit exercise lah on the closed loop, on the block diagram reduction. Okay, hari itu kita pun telah buat exercise block diagram reduction, tapi kita buat manually. Okay, kita juga boleh buat gunakan Scilab. Okay, let's say the block G1, G2, G3 and G4 is defined here. Okay, so you perlu modelkan all this G1 and until G4. Okay, and then after that, you can use the technique before. Okay, kalau you nampak yang ini, this basically is parallel, right? Jadi you boleh gunakan additional. Okay, and then after that, this block, nanti the result of this block akan jadi series dengan sini. Jadi you boleh multiply. Okay, and then the result of this, you akan dapati dia akan jadi close loop dengan G4. Okay, jadi you boleh gunakan yang close loop punya simplification. Okay, jadi kalau kita nak buat macam ni, to find the transfer function, jadi kita hanya perlu buat reduction. Okay, kalau kita tak define lagi the polynomial equation, kita define variable S sebagai polynomial equation. And then, kita modelkan satu persatu G1 until G4. Okay. Okay. Dan selepas tu, kita buat satu-satu operation. This one is parallel, kita perlu addkan dia. Okay. And then, this one is in series, kita perlu kalikan dia. Okay. And then, the result here dengan G4 ni is in loops. Kita perlu gunakan the loops. Ini, daripada results. Okay. Once we do this, we complete the transfer function. Okay. Daripada simple, daripada sistem seperti itu tadi. Okay. Okay, kita boleh cuba. Okay, kita modelkan G1. Satu lagi ya, bila you gunakan Scilab, kalau you malas type, you boleh tekan arrow up. Komand-komand yang you type sebelum ni akan keluar. Okay. Jadi you boleh padam saja, you boleh ubah mana yang perlu and then boleh run balik komand tersebut. Maksudnya you boleh edit dan boleh run the command. Okay. Satu lagi cara is kita copy paste tadi lah. Okay. It's another method. Kita ada G1. Okay, kita ada G2. Okay, kita ada G3. Okay, kita ada G4. Okay. And then now, tadi kita perlu add kan? Kita kata G1, 2, sama dengan G1 plus G2. Okay. Jadi kita dapat hasilnya. Kemudian kita ada G1, 2, 3 equal to hasil tadi G1, 2 kita kalikan dengan G3. Okay. And then lepas tu kita ada G all ataupun kita boleh tulislah G1, 2, 3, 4 pun tak apa. Okay. Sama dengan apa tadi? G1, 2, 3. Okay. Close loop dengan G4. Oops, sorry, sorry. Macam mana 4 ni? Okey, kita akan dapat hasil dia. Okey. You bayangkan, kalau you tengok dia punya polynomial equation sampai s to the power of 5. Kalau you buat by hand, saya rasa berapa minit akan ambil itu. Okey. Okay, so that's basically is time pun rasanya dah pukul 1. Any question on this? Okay. So basically yang Scilab ni pun dah cover semua the whole thing yang dalam chapter 2. Okay. Of course kalau you tengok dekat buku, dekat section yang last tu 2.10 rasanya. Rasanya that section dia describing macam mana nak gunakan MATLAB. Okay. Sama macam lebih kurang macam kita nak gunakan Scilab ini. Okay. Kalau siapa-siapa yang interested dengan MATLAB, boleh belajar yang tu, boleh baca yang tu. Okay. Tapi saya rasa tak perlulah. Saya rasa if you know the Scilab already, I think that's good enough. Because Scilab, the good thing is that later on kalau you pergi kerja, you boleh gunakan. Kan? Sebab the license is free. Walaupun you install dekat industri. Okay? Ini satu hadiah daripada saya sebenarnya kepada kamu. Dapat satu software free. Okay? Okay? Pelajar-pelajar bila ambil kursus dengan saya, setiap kali kursus dengan saya ada software free. Okay. Semasa lepas pun you dapat software free juga kan? Okay. Okay, kita akan jumpa lagi esok.